still so I can see. That's good. Now the other one. Good boy. Now, Danny, when you were brushing your teeth, do you remember if you smelled anything funny or saw any bright flashing lights or anything at all strange?
No.
Do you remember when you were brushing your teeth?
Yes.
What's the next thing you remember after you were brushing your teeth?
And I was saying, wake up, wake up, wake up, Danny, wake up.
Now, Danny, can you remember what you were doing just before you started brushing your teeth?
Talking to Tony.
Is Tony one of your animals?
No, he's a little bit that lives in my mouth.
Tony's his imaginary friend.
Oh. If you were to open your mouth now, could I see Tony?
No.
Why not?
Because he hides.
Where does he go?
To my stomach.
Does Tony ever tell you to do things?
I don't want to talk about Tony anymore.
Okay. That's fine. All right, Danny. I'm going to ask you to do me a favor and stay quietly in bed for the rest of the day, okay?
Oh, I have to?
Yes, I'd like you to.
We're just going to go in the other room for a few minutes and talk. And I'll come back and check on you, okay?
Okay.
Bye. Shall we go into the living room?
Yes.
Please.
Thank you. Mrs. Torrance, I don't think you have anything to worry about. I'm quite sure there's nothing physically wrong with Danny.
Yeah? Oh. Yeah, he seems absolutely fine now. But you should have seen him.
I know. Kids can scare you to death. But believe me, these episodes are not at all uncommon. And they look much worse than they are.
But what was the matter with him?
Mrs. Torrance, most of the time these episodes with kids are never explained. They're brought on by emotional factors, and they rarely occur again. They're more akin to auto-hypnosis, a kind of self-induced trance.
Feels so different.
Mm-hmm.
Dad?
Yes?
I'm hungry.
Well, you should have eaten your breakfast.
We'll get you something as soon as we get to the hotel, okay?
Okay, Mom.
Hey, wasn't it around here that the Donner Party got snowbound?